chest.
What happened?
I'll tell you later.
Hello, I'm Graham Stark.
And I'm Kathleen DeVere, and here are today's top stories. GameStop CEO Dan DiMatteo hung his head in shame this week as the company revealed that their 2009 holiday sales had merely remained steady, rather than rising over 20% as they had done in previous years. DiMatteo stressed to investors that this terrible result was in no way his fault, blaming winter storms and product shortages. He also said his grandma had been sick for most of December, and he's pretty sure a dog went around and ate all the sales reports at every single GameStop nationwide.
In a cost-saving measure, EA has announced that they will be shutting down the servers for many of their older games. "We would like to support all our games forever," the company said in a statement on their website, "but that just isn't practical. We want to stress that only really old games like Madden 09 and NASCAR 09 are being affected. I mean, seriously, is anybody still playing games from way back in 2009?
Target is offering a video game setup service. For the low price of $99, a Zip installation employee will come to your house and set up your console. The service consists of configuring your wireless router, polishing the intertubes, signing you up for Xbox Live, physically performing the delicate task of connecting your console to your television, and hanging out with you for a while and pretending to be your friend. It is rumored he will also give you 1,000 gamer score if you ask nicely, or give him your mom's phone number.
LG is looking to reinvent the TV experience by unveiling a new magic wand system that incorporates motion controls into a standard remote. "We saw a not insignificant spike in TV sales following the debut of the Wii because of people inadvertently flinging their Wiimotes into their televisions, damaging the screens," said Allison Thweebnot, an LG spokesperson. "We think it would be exciting for people to watch TV using motion controls, and also exciting for our quarterly sales targets to roll out an extremely slippery, unrestrained motion device to a population with poor motor skills."
Square Enix stocks fell sharply this week as company admiral Imperial Hot announced that Final Fantasy XIII would be the last game presented in the traditional JRPG style. Hot noted that Japanese RPGs need innovation to bring them in line with their Western cousins. Industry analysts suspect that this feigned attempt at creativity will delay Final Fantasy XV, Financia Solvencia, on a back of Fanboya until at least 2014.
And now our feature story. The American military has long been accused of using America's Army and other first-person shooter titles to recruit young people. This week, they have announced a new program that they hope will address these concerns and take modern military recruiting in a whole new direction. Jeremy Petter has more.
Whether shooting vaguely ethnic terrorists, blowing up orbital space stations with plasma grenades, or simply not speaking Russian, there's no question that today's first-person shooters portray extremely realistic scenarios. But does that translate into higher military recruitment numbers? I sat down with Colonel Hank Jetson, head of the military's new Interactive Entertainment Relations Bureau, to find out.
Yes. Yes. Without a doubt, America's Army has been very successful for us. In fact, we've been so pleased with the results that we've launched a new project codenamed Operation Poking Man to expand our efforts in this area.
Operation Pokemon.
That's right, Poking Man. You see, FPS titles are great for teaching skills such as marksmanship, circle strafing, and corpse humping, but the modern soldier requires a more wide variety of skills, many of which are overlooked in that genre. That's why we are broadening our approach to target video games that emphasize a different skill set.
Such as?
Well, as an example, we find that Sick Micro is very important for new officers, and so we have been reaching out to the StarCraft and Dawn of War communities to recruit their best and brightest.
So, mostly real-time strategy titles?
Not at all. We've had a lot of success with expert Cookie Mama players in the commissary. And most World of Warcraft players have the same amount of experience doing meaningless repetitive tasks, waiting around for stuff to happen, and seeing little or no positive improvement as a 5-year Afghanistan veteran.
But the program isn't without its critics. Dr. Laura Hawley.
This program is irresponsible. How would you like to be under the command of someone whose main qualification is hundreds of hours playing World of Warcraft? What if they had been playing as a hunter, which, as we all know, is easy mode? The results could be catastrophic.
The truth is, recruitment is only the first half of the operation. Rather than trying to find video games that provide the correct combat skills, in the future we hope to be proactive and adapt military technology to the knowledge and muscle memory that gamers have from whatever game is popular at the time. If I had my way, the next time you 5-star through the fire and flames on Expert, you could be training yourself to shoot down enemy aircraft with an AA battery.
But what is certain is, while the Army snaps up all of gaming's best and brightest, the rest of the world is left to wonder whether there will be enough mathletes remaining to fill the important roles of doctors, lawyers, and politicians in the years ahead. For ENN, this is Jeremy Petter, returning you to the studio.
Thank you, Jeremy. I feel safer and more protected already. Until next time, I'm Kathleen.
And I'm Graham, saying, up, up, down, down, left, right, BA, start. All right, what's up with the wrist?
I gave myself a repetitive strain injury.
Oh, what? How?
Playing Bejeweled on the iPhone.
You fool.
Yeah. Well, how'd your doctor's tests go, by the way?
Oh, good news, it's not herpes.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Doesn't know what it is, actually.
Oh.
But he's naming it after me.
Score!
Yeah.
Ow!
Ooh.
For ENN, this is Jeremy Petter, stumbling slightly and redoing his line.